Coming up on Hawk TV,
we take a look into the new Spanish immersion program,
Drumline's first competition of the year,
and volleyball's win on Tuesday.
I'm Jessica Hoyos.
And I'm Andres Lukic. The Spanish program is trying a new teaching method this year. Sofia Kraft gives us the story.
¿Te gusta saltar?
Last year, a group of foreign language teachers toured local schools with the interest of finding new learning methods.
We toured some schools that had a total immersion program, and then we also toured Independence Elementary right here in our feeder program. And at Independence, they do a dual language program, which means one day everyone studies their classes in Spanish and then the next day everything is in English.
As a result, the Spanish teachers have implemented the flipped live rotating immersion in their classes, making Hebron the first LISD high school to pilot this program. Students have A and B days in which they speak English one day and speak Spanish the next.
We felt like if we could emulate what they do at the dual language program, where you do a back and forth or an off and on kind of thing with the target language and then your first language, then maybe that would be a little bit better situation for the students to learn and get answers that they need.
In a full immersion program, students often find the Spanish speaking days to be more challenging. At the end of last year, Spanish 4 AP students only spoke in Spanish during class to prepare for the AP test in which there were no students that scored less than a 3. This year, teachers and students look to improve even more with the new immersion program.
When you're speaking Spanish more frequently, it's like easier to do the listening portions of the test and easier to write, because when we have Spanish days, we only speak Spanish, like we won't be allowed to speak English, and so it really helps you comprehend more and you have to really pay attention.
We do a lot of speaking, and it's a lot of listening, so being able to really have a conversation with someone in Spanish all day, it just really helps with your fluency. Just learning about Spanish, it's not enough when you actually speak it and you have to listen and really be able to understand it to do well in the class. That's when you're really going to learn the language.
Reporting for Hawk TV, I'm Sophia Kraft. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, Sophia. Drumline's first competition of the year is tomorrow. Courtney Foster shows us how they have prepared.
With the help of halftime performances and pep rallies, it has helped unify Drumline for the future competitions.
Well, we're here every morning, 5:30, 6, and on Mondays and Tuesdays we stay after school for rehearsals. On Fridays are football games, which also gives us a chance to put our stuff on the football field at halftime.
Well, in Drumline, it's just like any other sports organization, really, without the support of contact, I guess. But we really are dependent on each other to play the correct part, to fit in with each other. And when we all do our job, then together we come as one to really perform to the level that we want to.
This weekend is the 23rd annual Drumline competition, which is the first out of the two they have this year.
This is going to be our first Drumline contest, which is, we only have two a year. So this is where we figure out kind of where we stand in comparison to other lines, and we figure out what we need to work on in anticipation for the last one.
Reporting for Hawk TV, I'm Courtney Foster, now back to the studio.
Thanks, Courtney. We'll be right back. volleyball is 6-1 in district. Let's send it over to Spencer Rojas with sports.
Thanks, Andres. The football team got off to a strong first half Friday, leading 21-7 at halftime. During the second half, the offense went stagnant, and Marcus rallied back, bringing the game into overtime. Here's Brian Franklin with the story.
Holding the Marauders scoreless after the first two possessions, the Hawks had a chance to win the game. But after a blocked field goal, the team headed to a third overtime. Hebron got the ball first and had another field goal blocked, leaving Marcus a chance to seal the game. Marcus kicked a 37-yard field goal to end the game at 24-21.
Going into overtime, we had the momentum of the game, and we felt confident, and our kids battled for four quarters, and to ask them to go one more into overtime, I'd say they answered the call as much as they could.
The team has battled injuries all season, with many key players not able to play for the rest of the season.
Injuries has really impacted us key. A lot of our key players went down, and a lot of our D1 players went down from injuries, and so it affected the team as a whole, but people got to step up. That's really no excuse.
Injuries have been hard. Isaiah Gary, Zach Rogers, Antonio Montez, and Omar Hicks. Four of our best players are out, and of course it hurts the team a lot, but everybody else has rallied around themselves tremendously.
The team has had a rough start to district so far, starting off 0-2. The team needs a win tonight to stay in contention for a playoff spot.
In Louisville, now that we're 0-2 in district, we're really going to start going ham in practice and never taking any downs off and getting on each other's butts if we're not doing our jobs correctly.
The Hawks take on Louisville tonight at Max Goldsmith Stadium at 7:30. I'm Brian Franklin, now back to Spencer.
Thanks, Brian. The girls' varsity golf team is playing at Harbor Lakes this weekend. We'll be right back.
It's a dangerous love affair. Can't be scared when nickels down. Got a problem, tell me now. Only thing that's on my mind is who's gonna run this town tonight. Who's gonna run this town tonight? We gonna run this town.
Welcome back. The volleyball team is off to a strong 6-1 start in district. Now to Reese Woodhill with the story.
After sweeping Plano East in three games Tuesday night, the volleyball team looks to take on an undefeated McKinney-Boyd team.
I think the way we're going to prepare for the McKinney-Boyd game is by working hard in that weight room and running our mile on the track, and then just having good practices and working hard to make ourselves better.
The Hawks start the second half of district play next week with a chance to improve their play.
I think some of the things that we need to change would be, like, I guess we kind of need to communicate more on the court, because that was a lot of our problem when we lost the floor amount, which is our only loss this round.
We need to change how we react on defense. I think communication is key, too.
Volleyball plays at McKinney-Boyd tonight in a district matchup starting at 6 p.m. I'm Reese Woodhill, reporting for Hawk TV. Now back to Spencer.
Thanks, Reese. The cross-country team looks to continue their dominance this weekend at the Northwest Invite. That's all for sports. I'm Spencer Rojas, now back to the studio.
Thanks, Spencer. That's it for today's broadcast. I'm Jessica Hoyos.
And I'm Andre Sukic. Have a great rest of your day.